This episode of Motoring Box is proudly supported by Century Batteries.
Welcome back to Motoring Box. I'm Sean McKellar, and it's been a while, but I've been busy. And this is one of the little projects that I've had in the back of my head that I've been wanting to try for a long time. So what is actually going on here? Well, first of all, my BA XR6 Turbo has a triple gauge cluster on the dashboard, and I found out it doesn't always give you the most accurate information. For example, on the boost gauge, it'll sort of say that I'm hitting about 5 pounds of boost, but in reality, I'm hitting boost cut at 23 pounds. So it is really important with a performance car that you're getting accurate information. And seeing as the car has a Haltech plug and play ECU, I wanted to get a Haltech IC7 dashboard. And what I've made here is really inspired in my mind by the Nissan R34 GTR MFD display, which had a little screen in the center of the dash with various metrics, gauges, and things like that. So I wanted to see, first of all, whether that was possible utilizing the little dashboard triangle section. This is really far from perfect. And in a way, this is my Iron Man Mark I suit. It's really for a test, you know, does it work or not? Is this something I should pursue? And I think it is definitely something I'm going to be pursuing. As you see, when we install it into the car, there are some issues. And the biggest one I can think of is that Haltech's panel that they sell, that blank panel, it actually has really big radiuses around where it meets up to the IC7. That's probably the biggest issue. And you'll see that when we install it in the car, is that it is very high as a result. So when I make my Mark II, version, which I'll be doing soon, what I'm going to be doing first of all is trying to lower the IC7, so it might be recessing the bottom of it, but there's quite a big bezel here, so it's not going to hide the screen. And then just trying to reduce this top, because there's at least a centimeter between the top of the IC7 and the top of this, so it's probably the height the most that I need to get down, and I have an idea of how I'm going to do that. So let's drop this into the car. I'll show you how it works. And yeah, we can have a bit more of a chat about it. So these little notches here slot into the front. The fit is not quite perfect, but for a prototype, again, it works pretty good. So this one doesn't have the clips to clip it in at the back, but that is a fair indication of how it would sit. So I know what you're thinking. It looks very tall, and that's true. But like I was talking about before, if I recess the bottom of this by approximately half a centimeter, there's not a lot of depth, and then we lost this centimeter here on the top, you're gonna be down almost to where the top of the screen is at the moment. That would be the top of the whole unit. So I think that would actually look really good. So let's fire this thing up. I'll just turn the ignition on. And you can actually configure the colors of your IC7 as well. By default, they have a yellow and red kind of a Haltech color scheme. But I've configured this one to be more of an XR6 turbo color. At the moment, I have this center ring here as the boost pressure, because I don't need speed. I don't really need RPM either, because they're all down here. Got the air intake temperature, coolant temperature, oil pressure, which is not hooked up yet. Ignition angle, throttle position, battery. Got a speed indicator down here too. And I do have RPM as a number down here in the bottom. So to give you an idea of how that looks, so there it is again. We've got the RPMs, we've got the boost. You can see everything live. I think it's a pretty cool system. I'm really looking forward to getting it installed properly and looking respectable. But I really think this is going to do a fantastic job instead of running standalone gauges. You know, if you've got your gauges, you've got a maximum of 3. In particular with my previous gauges, they weren't trustable. They weren't providing accurate information, whereas this is straight off the ECU. Pretty cool. This is just one which I've configured the colors of and sort of swapped around, you know, what's displaying where. But they have a twin ring one, which is really good for sort of RPM and speed. But again, I've put boost on this one and I've kept RPM on that one, you know, swap these out to whatever metrics you want to show. A screen like this is more of a data-driven sort of a display. You can display more. Look, there's another one that's showing even more. But yeah, I think for what I'm doing, a screen like this is absolutely fantastic. So I've got an idea of how I can fix this and how I can make it look a lot better. We're nearly there. I think it's proven that the concept works. but it needs to be refined, and that's what we will do in a couple of weeks' time. So do let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, guys. Do you think this is cool, or do you think it's a little bit shit? Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, do subscribe, stick around, because we'll be revisiting this, that's for sure. I'll see you next time.